Hey, my name is Jimmy Rabin. I'm the Director of Product Management for Fortify, and I'm here today to quickly walk you through the susceptibility analysis feature in Software Security Center. The latest version of Software Security Center 20.2 includes a new view dedicated to susceptibility analysis and clearly showing the data of this feature between Sonatype and Fortify and what we can do when we combine forces together analyzing a single application. So the way this works is that both a Fortify SCA scan and a Sonatype invocation is done. So I will have a separate video for how we use the source and lib scanner, which is available directly on our marketplace. You can just Google Fortify source and lib scanner. You'll find us right there. That's a command line utility designed to facilitate the Fortify SCA scan and the Sonatype invocation. You can download that, and I will have a separate video on setting it up. But once we have invocated a Fortify SCA scan and a Sonatype component analysis scan of an application, the results are uploaded with that utility to Software Security Center. We simply need to go into the administrative section, go into the plugins and the parsers, and ensure that we have the Sonatype scan result parser enabled in SSE. You can click New to add it, and then you just need to specify the plugin jar, as you see here, from the Sonatype Fortify bundle that you download from the marketplace. So this includes both the parser plugin and, on the IQ server side, a Java service to sync issues, should you want to sync issues between IQ server and SSE. But really, for this, we're only concerned with the parser and the ability to ingest Sonatype findings into SSE. So once we have that parser enabled, we can go ahead and take a look at some of the results. So if we look at this particular project, this contains both Fortify SCA results and Sonatype results. And those are included. This is the normal default issue view where we show both third-party issues and Fortify SCA issues. But we have a new tab here dedicated to open source. So in this open source view, we will see all of our Sonatype findings. Only our Sonatype findings are in the open source tab. And what we are doing now is we are rolling these issues up for you, but providing some new fields to help you prioritize which components need to be upgraded. So if we look, we can see here that the struts2 core jar was actually invoked in your custom code, right? Fortify will tell you whether or not the function that was patched to fix this issue, as the Sonatype research team determined, is automatically passed to Fortify now, and custom rules are generated on the fly to determine whether you've invoked a function or method and whether uncontrolled user input can reach that function or method. In this particular case, we've simply seen that the function is invoked, but we haven't seen any actual data flow to suggest that there is directly a way to inject this attack. So anytime we have the CVE, we have the CWE, you have the ability to add an analysis tag or audit this issue right here in the user interface, add a comment. We can suppress the issue if the evidence leads us to believe we do not want to prioritize this issue for this particular version. And we have the specific evidence of how Fortify determined from the signature data from Sonatype whether you invoked this particular known vulnerability. If we click View Evidence, that will take us to the actual Fortify finding. So this is the result of the custom rule we generated to determine whether or not this component was actually invoked. So we can see here and clearly see that on line 79, we do invoke this particular function. This evidence is really only relevant in the context of a Sonatype finding, so it's hidden from view by design, unless you're clicking the View Evidence button. So you won't find this by just looking through your normal issues. You see this special search criteria we've generated when coming from the View Evidence link in the open source view. So now, with the combination of Fortify and Sonatype, you can truly help prioritize your open source issues. I should mention this is for Java only in the first release, and the way that we collect methods and function signatures is based on the requests that we receive for Sonatype invocations of known components. So as you request that Sonatype scan various open source components, we understand that any of those particular known vulnerabilities that have had updates, meaning that they have been patched, we'll generate a signature for that function or method so that we can see that the function that is actually in your own custom code and that you are utilizing that vulnerable component of the dependency. Not just that you have the dependency on your class path, but you've actually used it in a way that makes you susceptible to this particular vulnerability. So that will conclude this quick demonstration. Thank you very much.